So the four of you find yourself shoved to a table meant for two. It's incredibly cramped and uncomfortable. And it's right by the kitchen, so the door opens and someone gets hit in the head every time.
I wonder who, wait, who's sitting at the door?
I mean,
yeah.
Mario just went, ow, so kids start just getting thrown through the door every time someone comes out.
We're all looking at you. Do you want to trade with
me? No, it's fine. Okay. I'll just sit here on the edge. It's cool. So what exactly is our plan of attack here, gang? I mean, we can't just...
I was face down on the couch and also in the shower. I don't know why we're here. I thought we were just getting dinner.
Supposedly Red Dragon's got some sort of connection here. We just need to figure out what it is.
Oh.
I mean,
also steaks.
Chances are he's not just going to be sitting out in the midst of things.
We can't
exactly
just
stand up and shout out his name.
Look, it's probably going to be like a secret passage or something. Do you guys want to, you know, like sneak into the kitchen, see if there's like a back entrance or underground passage or anything like that?
Yeah. But let's eat first.
I agree.
All right, so we all order a steak.
It's got an onion ring on it. It's real nice.
It's super fancy. Yeah. None of you can afford this.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I can.
Dine and ditch?
Because well, I mean, disappear into the kitchen. So.
Okay, this
Nicole
is a place that has like $15 for fries.
Are they good fries?
They're the best fries you've ever had.
They like, they have truffle fries?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah. I understand that.
They're like truffle fries.
But it's still
truffle Earl on those.
Actual truffles.
This is like the Pikey prices.
Yeah. Well, out of guilt, after we eat, I will leave all the money I have on the table, which will be about $5.03. 37 cents.
So what do you guys do after you have your lovely steak dinner? And you possibly suffer concussion because you keep getting blocked from that door.
I like Swole's idea of going in the kitchen and sort of as discreetly as we can, trying to find an entrance. I'm gonna look in the freezer, cause, you know, secret entrance.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, like Clue.
Exactly. I'm gonna kind of make my way out back and like
goes to the conservatory,
search around there. But we've all got our communicators, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So let's just say as soon as someone finds something, get the whole group in on it.
Split the party again. Why not?
Yes.
Well, more of a search this time. We won't get that far away from each other. We don't want to repeat.
All right, so who's checking what? You have a restaurant, there's a back to it.
I'm
going to
check out back and see if there's like, you know, one of those like cellar door things that
I'm checking
they
the walk-in.
Often used to store stuff.
I'm going to actually stay in the dining area.
Okay.
Just in case, you know, somebody comes out in there. Also because they know me, so it would look suspicious if I were to be moving about.
And Kevin?
I mean, I guess I'm just going to follow somebody.
Who are you following?
I'll follow Kid Stardust.
Okay. All right.
Check the walls, like, especially in the back. I mean, it's like a perfect place for a secret entrance, right?
Pull the particular meat hook.
Exactly.
So, I mean, I say, like, maybe to myself, and I hope others can hear me, like, guys, I don't think it's going to be this complicated.
We'll start with you two real quick.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right.
Even though we're doing totally separate things?
Yes. Okay. You, and then you two.
Okay.
All right, so, Charlie.
Yes.
You decide to just kind of sit at the table, watch the dining room?
Yes.
All right.
It's like a corner booth, so it's like good to, it's got good views.
Okay. So, one of the busboys, who looks kind of rough around the edges.
Yeah.
Goes up to the maitre d', gets real close, looks over his shoulder, whispers something, and the two of them kind of head out the front door.
Hmm. That's particular.
You also notice that a lot of the wait staff look... What'd you name the...
Daniel?
Yeah.
The maitre d'?
Yeah. They don't all look as foppish as Daniel.
Daniel kind of puts on an act, too. He wears fashion capes.
Fop and foppish are like some of my favorite
I have a coworker
words.
That wears fashion capes.
Such a good word.
Oh my
Hashtag God. Bring back fop.
Bring back fop. More fops.
More fops.
Fallout.
When my boss said, oh yeah, James W. wears capes, I was like, when you say capes, do you mean like nerd capes or fashion capes? And he goes, fashion capes. I'm like, oh my God. It's one of my coworkers in New York.
I want to.
Never met him.
I wish to fall off capes.
Anyway, So I say into the, they all just look kind of like on edge.
No, they look kind, they look like they should be working maybe at like a steel mill or at the wharf. They don't really look like they fit in with the environment of this fancy ass restaurant.
Yeah, it's, this is a new waitstaff. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because that's not usually what it is. They're usually very energetic, very, you know. So I say into the earpiece, hey guys, the waitstaff is acting very peculiar. It's actually not the usual waitstaff. I mean, we're here all different times, you know, all different days of the week, and there are different people. Also, Daniel, the maitre d', and one of the busboys just went out the front door.
That doesn't seem right.
No, it's not.
Swole, how's it going out there?
So I imagine I'm getting Atlas to, like, help sniff around for anything suspicious, too. Am I seeing anything?
You're not seeing a whole lot back here.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like there's anything out back here.
You hear voices coming from around the corner, though.
Okay, I'm going to go radio silent for a moment, and I kind of go around and just, like, listen in on what's going on back there.
All right. Look, it's not my fault. He said it was overdone. What do you mean overdone? You know the boss likes his meat very particular.
The boss?
Yeah, I go, hey, there might be going on something back here. You heard something about the boss? I'm going to keep listening to these guys.
Cool.
The boss?
So, can I have a conversation with Kid Stardust?
Yeah, you two managed to sneak into the kitchen with very little trouble. You just kind of... herd of waiters go in, you go in with them. They gave you a lovely dining jacket, so I was just gonna like...
Mm-hmm. Or I can use my illusions to make us dress like the waitstaff.
You can do that. Actually, I like that better.
Yeah. I do that.
Yes.
I never have done that before, but I just wanted to add some flair today.
Yeah, no, you can actually... We forget, you have a really good power.
It's pretty useful sometimes.
Illusions, Michael.
Illusions, Dad.
Or candy.
So, hey, Kid Stardust, you're gay, right?
In the freezer, still dressed as waitstaff, or at least illusion to look like waitstaff.
She just looks at you like... yeah. Yeah.
It does occur to you. A couple weeks ago, this guy didn't seem to even realize you had a girlfriend. Right.
I just got a real quick for a moment. I've been trying to watch all the Oscar movies, and there's one of the foreign movies called A Man Named Ove or something like that, and it's like a Swedish movie. And he's like this crotchety old man, and there's a scene in a restaurant where he's talking with this Iraqi refugee young boy or whatever, and he's like got like dark makeup on his eyes and stuff. He's like, oh, I wear makeup. Are you like one of those gays? And like everyone's like, no, don't. And the guy's like, yes, I am one of those gays. He's like, and he turns everyone. He's like, so why are you guys getting on my case about this? Like, all right,
he was.
I was right, right? It's a really good movie. Actually.
It sounds dramatic.
I love the Swedes.
So I follow that up with like, so. Did you always know?
Well, I mean...
I love that we're having this conversation now.
In a freezer.
In a freezer.
Chaos Law doesn't know when to have these conversations.
He's got a lot of things on his mind.
I don't know. I mean, like, when I was a little girl, I didn't really think about it too much. And, you know, I didn't really like boys, but I figured I would just kind of, you know, grow into it. But, I don't know, once... puberty came along and decided that, you know, I just like girls. I don't know.
Uh-huh.
I never really gave much thought to it. Just seemed the thing to do for me.
Weird. Cool.
can I ask why you're asking?
No, you can't.
No.
Yeah. She kind of narrows her eyes. Okay.
Cool.
Well, know that if you have any other questions about that kind of thing, you can talk to me, okay?
Yeah, cool. Thanks.
I mean, you know, be respectful. I'm not gonna... Don't be you. I guess is what I'm saying.
Wow. Whatever.
Wow.
No, I mean that.
It's good advice.
Wow.
Amazing. And then I want to like hope that in Chaos Lot's mind, enough time goes by between this and the next question. But in reality, no.
There's like a beat panel and then.
Right.
So your sister, like when she's angry, how angry is she?
What?
You look away from the hams you were like sorting through, like.
Oh, nothing. Never mind. Let's just keep finding this guy.
What?
Because I'm worried. Chaos Lot's gonna break her heart somehow.
Out of character. Yeah. You remember? You remember crazy explosion anger battle earlier with her. So
she did kind of lose her goddamn mind there, and then brought you to Yogurt Land to talk.
Yeah. Well, I made her still go flooded. To Yogurt Land.
Still flooded.
Anyway. We go back to looking.
It doesn't take you long after your wonderful little outburst for you to find a tile that's stuck out a little bit too far. Your hand presses into it, and the back of the freezer swings open.
Told you.
False door. False wall.
So maybe it is a little more complicated than I thought.
It's your body's body. It's not there.
God, now I want to watch Clue.
I do too. God, I love that movie.
Watched on Thanksgiving.
That's what I'm gonna do.
That sounds like a great way to spend Thanksgiving.
It's pretty great. Mm. And then we played Drinking Quest, which was also a good way to spend Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Drinking Quest is a role-playing game and a drinking game. Look it up.
There's no downside to this.
I'm sorry, but aren't all role-playing games drinking games?
Well, this actually has mechanics built in to hasten the drinking.
My friends and I are gonna try and figure out how to play True American, a game from New Girl.
There's some great like guidelines for how to play it online.
Yeah.
Like I found a really good game for it and we played it with some of my friends back in
You need to watch New Girl, first of all. And True American is gold.
I've tried. I can't stand it.
Oh, I love New Girl so much. I actually really love Zooey Deschanel.
So it really grew on me. Like at first I was like, she is gonna be really annoying. And after I'm like, no, she's great.
Yeah, no. After the first season, like they tuned down the adorkableness.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah.
So
it's been better.
I just love Nick, like he has that like that angry stink face all the time.
The false wall opens up and it's still very cold. It feels like it's just a continuation of the freezer. It even has a nice sterile frozen quality to it. But you see what kind of looks like a T-Rex skull spray painted on the far wall.
What? One, I think that's cool.
It is cool.
Take a picture of it with your phone.
No, I left my phone in my jacket. That's gone now. Homeless right now.
That's gone now.
Man, so I'm going to need you to help me out with another phone.
I can't make phones.
Oh, well then how do we get
phones? I can fix phones.
Go to the store.
Yeah, I can
ask your mom who pays for your phone still.
I can't get you a phone though. You got to have like a carrier and stuff like that.
She's mad at you for a lot of
reasons,
kid.
I can't sign you up for T-Mobile.
You run away from home and live in like a squatter shack, but then when you need a phone, suddenly you're cool with your family.
I might not get another phone. That might be the thing.
You can always get a burner phone.
Prepaid. We'll go to 7-Eleven after this, we'll get you a burner phone, okay?
Fine.
All right.
Phone. You recognize it though. Okay. The T-Rex skull. It's the symbol of the Carnosaurs.
Uh-oh. That ain't good.
They're a local gang, mostly known for like some pretty hardcore shit.
Guys, we just found something interesting, and I'm a little concerned. But let me get back to you in a sec, okay?
Wait, do you need us to come in and back you up?
I mean, this might be the only answer we're looking for. They might not find anything where they are at.
Stay where you are for the moment, okay?
Okay, but I'm ready to come in if you need it.
Okay.
Guess I'll just keep listening in on the people outside.
As you hang up, you feel your hand twitch.
I'm gonna be, hey, just getting a feeling that it may be more discreet if I come in now instead of, say, in the next 60 seconds.
Ah, yeah. Okay, straight through the walk-in.
All right, I'll be there.
Who's there?
Just looking for a place to piss.
The waiter rolls up his sleeves and he looks pissed. He's coming up.
Alice, go for the nuts! I'm gonna
can you do that?
Yeah, I'm gonna sick Atlas on him, and then I'm gonna.
We're not miming that.
Mm-mm. Aren't we?
Nope.
Oh, or at least, actually, more realistically, I'll have Atlas just like bite his leg.
Hold on. 1 second.
What are you doing?
Let's try that.
Oh!
Atlas, go for the nuts!
Row!
Nuts!
Atlas went for the nuts.
That's okay. What I mean.
That's adorable.
I figured since y'all were worth it? On them,
let us know.
Use the facilities.
Can we do a straw poll?
Actually, instead of running inside, I'm gonna see if when Atlas can Jojo. Like attack them.
Jojo?
Yeah.
I can just knock him out.
Okay.
Yeah, I wanna try and just like knock him out without making two huge scenes.
Alright, you don't have to roll for that. Atlas goes for the nuts. Actually, I'm gonna take one. He goes for the nuts.
Cool.
And you just punch one guy and elbow and punch the other guy.
I'm coming in. Might need to make this a little fast.
Okay. By the way, Carnosaurs.
Oh, fun!
Yeah.
So where are we at right now? Sorry, I had to pee.
They opened up the false door in the false wall in the freezer.
Yes.
He heard something about the boss.
I was here for that.
What do we know about the Carnosaurs?
They are known for bank robberies, terrorism attacks, drug wars. They are some serious dudes.
Do we know they're related to cannibalism at all?
No.
Okay.
What cannibalism? I don't remember that.
Guys, seriously?
Being revealed.
I know.
No, it hasn't. That's why I'm asking I know. We know that they're related to
out of character, I know so much about cannibals, you guys. Uh-huh. It's great. I'm probably on
well, in character, you made yourself a frequent diner at a place that serves human meat, so.
They call it Long Pig.
Long Pig.
From something?
I actually have, in real life, I have because I wrote a pilot about cannibals, I had to like figure out like how you properly, I actually have a page bookmark that's like, how to properly butcher a human carcass, and I'm like, oh, I'm definitely on some on some NSA watch list right now.
Yeah.
Dude, you deserve to be.
I know, all the shit I look up, like seriously, serial killers and...
All right.
I'm probably gonna be arrested.
Not as dangerous as a Muslim.
Cool. Apparently,
according to the watch list now.
Or a uterus.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
I don't think they consider that particularly dangerous. Mm.
It could birth a terrorist.
That's true.
2017 was supposed to be better than 2016, I'm just gonna say it.
2017
No, I knew it was gonna be shit.
Anyway.
Yeah. Fantasy role-playing.
So let's head in.
So the four of you are back in the freezer. Carnosaur logo. You notice at the end of the freezer as well, by the giant spray-painted logo, there's a set of stairs that goes down.
I don't wanna, but we gotta, right? We gotta?
That's all right.
I think we gotta.
We gotta.
I mean, we could turn around, but we gotta.
Is Charlie with us, or are you still in the dining room?
Jack's just laughing. I'll come to wherever you guys are.
All right, cool. Mm-hmm. We're going towards the conservatory.
Great.
I've never actually played Clue.
Mm. I've only played it once.
Never played it.
Clue, great game. It is one of my favorite
board
games.
I was supposed to play that one time, but the new guy wanted to play and I stepped down so he couldn't. Anyway.
I remember that.
Yeah. So you guys go down and it's really dark and it's really cold. And it looks like there's a lot of hanging meats down here.
Okay.
Yeah.
For a second, I'm like, hey guys, look, I'm Rocky.
Funny, you thought it'd be firmer than that.
Huh.
Wait, so did we just establish that it was humans?
We haven't in character established that yet.
Well, they're about to in like 3 seconds.
Sure. Speaking of which, how are you as far as transformation goes?
I'm still a regular person, but it's starting to.
Oh, it's coming soon.
Okay.
Yeah, I feel it coming on. Okay. But I do the Rocky thing for a bit.
Do you have your eye and mesh stuff?
I have it with me. I bring it whenever I'm a regular person.
Good call.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Even though it's broke?
It's not broken. It just got knocked out.
Cool.
I think.
All right.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No.
Probably have a spare back in the
Nothing's broken. So, feels a lot softer than...
Huh.
Thank you.
This is strange. I, like, kind of examine it.
And a human face looks back at you.
Hey, guys. Huh. The meat hears people. Meat hears people.
What?
Yeah, I'm gonna find a corner and throw up real quick.
Is that what we ate?
Wait, did we just eat?
Oh my god! Oh my god!
Yeah.
Oh, no. Jesus Christ!
All the hanging meat seems to be people.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We're.
Don't tell Katie.
Don't tell Katie. Oh no.
Oh god! Now you're gonna go vegan.
Wait. So did we really eat human?
Yeah, more than likely.
We all had a steak here.
Yeah, but are the steaks really? They
tyrant,
also have
tyrant
cows?
Steaks are made of people.
You've got 7 things marked on a frequent user.
Oh, card. I'm gonna have PTSD after this. Mm-hmm. Like, seriously.
So I throw up real quick. Definitely make that happen. What the fuck? What the actual fuck? So I imagine we're all like trying to be kind of quiet, but like freaking the fuck out down here. Oh my god! Oh my god! There's people down here.
I throw up shit. Without a problem.
I feel like it's blink.
The thing is,
no big deal.
When you eat the strange things that you eat in a hobo commune, you
actually
have to be prepared to throw up at any moment.
Kevin also discovered he doesn't have together. A gag reflex, which will come in handy at some point in his life.
In his life, yeah.
We were
once
just
again. I'd like to thank Sci-Fi T-Rex for this.
Remember,
so he made it human.
Yeah, he made it.
We love cannibals. Thank you so much.
Remember we were having fried rat and then trying out the various hobo cuisines.
Yeah, no, I know. That's what I'm saying.
whenever
we eat something that we think, oh, I probably don't want this in my body, I will be able to throw it up in a moment's notice. Because hobos, while they are good cooks, they might accidentally throw in rat poison with their rats.
Yeah.
So I was not, I didn't have a problem throwing up.
Yeah, the rat had rat poison in it because they found it dead.
Yeah.
I want it known that earlier this week a roach crawled out of my sink and I kind of had a freak out and had to scrub everything. I'm having that feeling right now.
No.
Like Creepshow style?
Duh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I hate bugs.
Fucking Creepshow. Yeah, don't watch Creepshow then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch Naked Lunch.
I just want to.
Yeah.
Oh. Damn it, Dom!
I love cannibals.
I tried reading
bugs.
Naked Lunch and I couldn't do it because my head hurt.
I don't know what Naked Lunch is.
Naked Lunch is a novel by William S. Burroughs that is...
It's like drugs.
In some people's... it's nonsense, basically.
Yeah,
it's drug ramblings.
It's nonsense.
But okay. David Cronenberg made a movie of it in the 90s.
Somehow.
Yeah.
Oh,
with
boy.
RoboCop in it.
Oh, boy.
Nice.
Well, Peter Welling.
The actor, not actually the character RoboCop.
Right,
that would have been so
much
better.
That would have been a great movie, though.
That would have been
Someone
so much better.
Make a movie
I think it would have made
RoboCop
more sense.
It, though.
Yeah.
It was called RoboCop.
Oh, they made 2 movies.
They made several.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
But
amazing.
He's only actually in RoboCop 2.
Mm. Peter Welling?
No, RoboCop.
Oh. Yeah, right.
Oh.
It's a weird twist.
Yeah.
Nobody saw it coming.
For the first one, they're just like, you know what would be cool? A RoboCop.
Well,
they're like, yeah, we'll try and make that
first
movie.
Mass tangent.
All right, so
mass tangent.
Yes. Wait, I get the joke you're making there.
Thank you.
Great joke.
How far back does this particular little storage thing go?
It goes for a while, but you see kind of a faint light, sort of like a couple lamps have been set up way in the back.
Let's go do this shit.
Okay.
All right. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
quickly. So yeah.
As you get there, you see a long dining table with a man that kind of looks like Killer Croc,
mm-hmm.
but red and more with a snout.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie, you would know
yes.
him right off the bat. This is T-Rex.
Oh, shit.
Yes. He's the leader of the Carnosaurs.
Okay.
And he has a very bloody steak in front of him.
When they always undercook it.
What did you say his name was?
T-Rex.
T-Rex? Okay. T-Rex.
One of our Patreon backers.
T-Rex. What the fuck, man?
He puts his fork down.
That's how you're
over.
Starting this obvious battle?
Oh, I didn't know what was happening. Just kidding. stars checking Twitter.
He's a known supervillain who runs the mob carnivore.
We've now found out has been serving us human meat.
I'm mad.
And is eating possibly human himself.
Where did he get the humans from?
All right, element of surprise.
I haven't gone missing at the den recently.
No!
Were you guys hiding?
Hobo Joe!
Yes! No. We're sneaking in there underground!
I recognize some people!
You never named them!
We're getting this. Well, you know what? We're just going in.
You just see us walking!
I'm traumatized!
Them up.
I'm
adding one to the pool for combat, adding one for the pool
for
influence.
You know what? I'm gonna even, you know, I'm gonna mark a condition. I'm angry. I feel lied to, betrayed to.
Yeah, I'm angry too.
Like,
these are
I don't give a shit if we're
way.
Sneaking. You know what? Fuck it. I said the thing. It's happening. I was checking Twitter. It's my fault. So.
It is your fault. This
whatever.
Is why I put my phone on airplane mode.
Oh, whatever. Hey, I grew
am
a
I still
tree.
Angry and insecure?
You can clear Twitter. A condition.
Okay, can I clear guilty?
I'll let you clear it.
Yeah. I mean, it's been a while.
I mean,
I'm not
I'm,
angry anymore, but I'm still insecure.
I was afraid from being hit by the mooks, but I'm guessing I'm still afraid.
Well, you just ate people.
I'm angry because it's like I feel so lied to.
Well,
it was
I'm
so
angry.
Delicious.
And
you had it for lunch yesterday.
Like
with
that was
Baba beans
like
and that's
like that's my like this is like our family's like special place that we go to eat like for.
Wait,
all
wait,
sorts
you guys
of
decided
stuff.
Your special place is gonna be a place called Tyrants?
It's really close. It's really close to home. Why the fuck you gotta judge?
I'm sure there's someplace else closer to home.
No. They live in the suburbs. There's like a gated neighborhood. God, give them a break.
God, Charlie's loaded.
Yeah. Except that his dad is like the you know, the traditional like immigrant story, like came from Poland with nothing. Like, it's annoying. And then his mom's a fucking brilliant scientist. Like, of course they're fucking loaded.
One day we're gonna have to explore the fact that she may or may not be responsible for you.
I think there's a pretty damn good chance
Luck.
She's responsible. Luck. She had all the files on her computer.
Mm-hmm. But this is neither the time nor the place.
Sure.
You're in combat right now
Luck.
With T-Rex. He is very Luck. Big.
I'm traumatized. We're going in.
And everyone has that brief moment of, he's an idiot.
Charlie just... All right, let's okay. do this.
he picks up the table and he swings it at the four of you. I need everyone to roll to take a powerful blow.
That's 5.
You're good. Mark potential.
And that's my next
what?
Raise, yeah.
Well, I take a pretty powerful blow.
Oh, no.
Well, we'll settle that for now.
I got 7. Do I
you also
that?
You also take the powerful blow.
Am I not able to defend for him, or
I will let you defend, but you'll take the hit instead.
Well, you have to still roll for your take a powerful blow.
That's true.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you don't know if you've got hit yet.
No.
Do you have any conditions?
I've got 1.
So that's a 7.
I have to add that.
Right.
Okay. So I choose 1.
Yeah.
I'm going to take a move from another playbook, but I'll look them over after this session and get back to you.
All right. We lost our brother? No? Okay, cool.
So I'm going to say that I...
I'm going to struggle past the pain and mark 2 conditions.
I'm going to say job. I give ground and you give your opposition an opportunity.
I just want to thank Sci-Fi T-Rex for this because we haven't had a lot of of our Patreon backers taking advantage of I'm a mob boss
mm-hmm.
with a district and a lot of cronies.
Mm-hmm.
So the fact that I get to actually play with this is super fun.
Yep, and then some of us aren't paying attention and then we just launch into combat.
Love it.
You're welcome, guys.
Should we deal with my...
Yeah, since
plus.
You rolled a 10 plus, what are your options and what are you choosing?
The options are you must remove yourself from the situation, flee, pass out, etc. You lose control of yourself or your powers in a terrible way, or 2 options from the 7 and 9 list.
I feel like this would be a good opportunity for you to stop the Atlas Shrugged.
That's what I was going to say.
This is definitely the end of the Atlas Shrugged.
I think this knocks me out and then, like, I, you know, lose control of my powers and, like, freak out and, like, do my Cronenberg, like, burst forth kind of thing.
All
right. And I'll say I start, like, kind of flailing out as that's happening. Like, because he just whacks me with a fucking table.
And it's like a table, imagine this, but, like, 4 or 5 feet longer.
Uh-huh. So basically I'm just, like, having basically a swole seizure against the wall, which is like, and just, like, smashing holes in the walls as, like, all my muscles are just, like, spasming and reverting back to the giant, big swole.
Yeah. Maybe you're having issues because it's a temperature thing. You're used to being in like normal temperature, but now it's like colder, and that's why it's like affecting.
It's,
like
when it's probably a combination. Yeah,
because your muscles get tight when it's cold, you know. So that's got to be like the temperatures are affecting that.
Probably a combo.
I'm just coming up with a reason why you're freaking out.
Guys, what are you choosing?
I'm choosing that to lose control of myself or my powers in a terrible way.
Okay.
Yeah.
We will deal with that after.
Cool.
We deal with everyone else. You are fine. Mm-hmm. You basically just jumped over it.
Mm-hmm.
Or how did you?
No, I kind of. Well, if you swing it, I feel like I ducked and then stood up very coolly.
And since you guys also failed the roll, Nicole, Jack, what are you choosing?
For the take a powerful blow?
Yes.
I marked two conditions.
Okay.
And struggled past the pain.
What conditions are they?
They're guilty and afraid.
All right.
And I'm also still angry.
Mm-hmm. And I said that I gave ground and he gets, I'm guessing it's opportunity against me in particular.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Which is since fine. You were the one that called
That's
him
fine.
Out.
That's fine.
All right. Jordan, I'm going to need you to attack one of your teammates as you, it's not an intentional attack, but it's more just like.
Sure, but it just like lashes out spasm. And at somebody nearby.
Yeah. Could just be like a.
I'm gonna say it's Stardust because we were both kind of like
yeah
the like oh, all right let's do this so I imagine we kind of like
we
started
vanguard.
Charging in together yeah. And then I imagine like my arm just like whips out and like smacks you across the face so is that
dodged,
would that be directly engage a threat just roll
the table.
That or?
just roll me a flat roll
okay not a good one so that's probably good for
we don't have any rerolls.
I could be an asshole and make you re-roll that, but I'm treating
whatever
it the way
you
I treat your explosions, where the lower the better.
Okay.
So, you get backhanded by Swole, but you're still standing and you don't have to mark a condition or anything.
Yeah, you manage to, when you're coming up from the table, you get just biffed
just
in the
get,
face.
You get biffed by a hand that's like...
Oh, and she shoots you a look.
The size of a medium Domino's pizza.
Yeah.
I'll also say I'm out of action for the next round while I'm rolling up. And I'm
also
because the bathroom.
Yeah.
Okay.
We all really had a pee this
session.
All right, session.
I'm going to try to comfort and support. Who has too many conditions?
I've only got one.
I've got one. I think Swole's got a whole bunch. No, he cleared him.
Oh, so. Okay. I have a ton.
Right.
You got this, Kevin. It's okay. It's okay.
In the future, if
you
somebody
need to learn
wants
how to self-soothe.
If someone wants to comfort and or support me, let
oh,
me
yeah.
know.
Oh, I will hella comfort and support you.
So I'm not going to comfort and support that.
Good call.
I'm going to defend. Who's in most danger of being attacked?
Well, we're...
Charlie.
Me. So I'm going to try to defend you.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Do it, do it, do it, do the thing.
Eight plus
your
savior
which
eight.
I'm guessing is not.
No, it's zero. It's so
it's
eight.
Yeah.
Okay.
So for PCs, on another
for NPC
on
threats
hit.
On a hit, you keep them safe and choose one. On a 7 and 9, it costs you expose yourself to danger or escalate the situation. Add a team to the pool. Take influence over someone you protect. Clear a condition.
Wait, so on a 7 to 9, it costs you. So I get to clear a condition?
Yeah.
Cool.
Awesome.
I will definitely do that.
Okay.
What do I want to clear? What do I want to clear?
So, while you're deciding that, T-Rex is coming towards you.
All right.
And you realize he's about 8 feet tall.
Yeah.
Mostly dinosaur. You little shits aren't stopping this, robbery. We've been planning this for months. And he scoops you up and it looks like you're gonna bite your head off, and then he takes an illusion bolt to the temple.
Who does? Me?
He, T-Rex.
Oh, I did that?
You defended
him.
Oh, sweet.
You didn't really go into detail, so I filled him in for you.
Wait. Yeah, but then he attacks me, right?
Oh yeah, he's totally coming after you now.
Okay, great.
But he's dropped Charlie.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So if I had gotten a plus, if I had gotten a plus 10, oh, there's nothing for plus 10. Never mind. Okay.
I realize I should have used never give up, never surrender instead of take a powerful blow, but that's all right. Too late now.
That's fair.
That's okay.
All right, so you have a T-Rex coming towards you.
Yeah.
You're just talking about bank robberies and shit.
Uh-huh.
Very thick Italian accent. He's, who's the guy from Sopranos?
Tony Soprano?
The actor.
Oh, James Gandolfini?
Yeah.
The late, great James Gandolfini.
He's voiced by the late, great James Gandolfini.
You come to this restaurant.
Okay, that's not
this.
James Gandolfini.
I don't know
that's
this
the
is.
Godfather. That's
the Godfather.
Dom
that's
DeLuise?
Marlon Brando.
Dom DeLuise?
Is that Dom DeLuise doing Marlon Brando?
Yes.
Yeah. No?
Marlon Brando.
I've never seen
like
The God.
Yeah.
I've never seen The Godfather, any of them.
James Gandolfini. I can't do it. Can't do it. Never mind. Don't listen to me.
Okay. Anyway, so he's coming for me. So what's happening?
Well, you shot him in the side of the head with an illusion bolt.
Yep.
And I'm going to go ahead and say he has a tail as well.
Great. Like a T-Rex tail?
A T-Rex tail.
Ooh, is
Yikes.
He covered in feathers or does he not believe in that?
I'm going to go ahead and say he was designed in the 90s, so...
Okay, so that was before...
The current redesign has him with some feathers, but it's mostly, like, replaced his hair.
Oh, it's like a mohawk of feathers.
I love it.
A little bit.
Yeah, sweet. I am on board.
Yes. So, he... Well, what do you... Let's see, defending it, dropped you... Roll take another powerful blow as the tail comes at you.
Can I defend?
You can't just keep turns defending.
Yes, we can.
Yeah.
Nice failure.
Mark potential as you dodge it. Tell me how you dodge it.
Well, the tail's coming for me, so I fall back kind of Matrix style with my knees still up and go, whoa! And then I flip back up and I go, whoa.
Whoa. I'm good at gymnastics.
I'm good at being bendy.
Yes. So that was his turn. You haven't gone, mm-hmm. and you're out for the round, so.
All right, I want to directly engage this motherfucker.
Just engage that threat?
Kind of power up some energy in my fist and just take a couple swings at him.
All right, do you have burn for that?
That's just a special effect.
Oh, okay.
I'm not doing anything special, I'm just punching him.
Gotcha.
Nice.
Yeah. So that's plus danger.
9 plus danger.
That's
10.
Nice.
Yeah.
Bitches.
Okay. So I want to resist and avoid his blows. So dodging the tail and stuff, and creating an opportunity for my allies by distracting him and just kind of really getting in his face.
All right. So between the two of you, he has all his attention on you right now. Mm-hmm. But you are way faster than him. Mm-hmm. He's very fat. I mean, he's very strong and very powerful, but.
But he's a dinosaur, so he moves kind of slow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Charlie, what do you do?
I want to take, because we're like still in like a freezer basement, right?
Yeah.
There's still like meat hanging all over this with like meat hooks and shit.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so.
There's people on them.
So, okay. I don't know. I'm used to imagining this. yay, writer's brains. So I am just going to. Basically, with my powers, take all the meat hooks, even the ones that like have people on them. Just drop all the bodies, and just
hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
Oh my God, the cockatiel that does that. Yes. Oh, so fucking good.
Anyone? I think it was the cat bouncing or counting souls. One of those. Yeah, yeah. And he goes no.
Yeah. So good.
I just saw a cockatiel doing SpongeBob SquarePants and ending with a do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
That's adorable.
Really
great. So that's reshaping your environment. Roll to freak out.
That's right. That's fucking right. Because I swapped all of my, I swapped my labels, and so now I have, instead of -1 freak, I have +2 freak.
Yeah, you do. Oh,
so. Freak out.
Okay.
Nope.
Ain't good.
Super no.
Hey, chat, none of us have rerolls.
I do.
We know.
I'm very tempted to be nice and throw you a bone.
It's up to you.
Yeah.
I'm going to throw you a bone.
Oh my God, Steven.
I mean, we've had a tough day in this.
Have you? Have you really?
There you go.
Much better.
That's the alpha and the omega.
So 14. So I like super hurl all of the meat hooks and try to like stick them in his body.
You manage to hook him like it's fucking Hellraiser.
Ooh, nice. Or like when Chris Angel was hanging from hooks.
I prefer
in Mind Freak.
I don't want to think Chris Angel.
I don't know the reference, but I'm going to say yes.
No, be happy you don't
know.
Chris
Angel does all his stuff.
He just what?
All
right, marking two conditions for that. Real.
Wait, no, I'm thinking of David Blaine.
David marking two conditions on him for that.
Yeah. Sweet.
Sweet. Okay. As you hook him, he seems to get really kind of like freaked out for good reason.
Yeah, absolutely.
Jesus, Charlie.
I'm fucking mad.
Yeah, but
he fed
dark.
Me people for years.
Yeah, but
I'm mad because these are my brethren.
And those steaks were really good.
They are. I might know some of them.
They season these steaks really well.
Yeah.
It's upsetting.
And
they charge so much for it.
And even if they're not my brethren, I'm still very angry because these are people who don't deserve this. They're people with faces and lives, and even though society ignores them, I'm going to fight for them.
Well said, Kevin.
Thank you.
And I'm just like...
Everything stops for half a second, so like, everyone can be like, wow, Kevin does have a heart and a brain.
But
I'm
no
just,
courage.
I'm still just so enamored with you.
Good.
Both as Charlie and as Jack.
There you go.
And both. Kevin and Nicole.
Friendship. So, freaking out, he picks up Swole, who still kind of sees
it. Oh, shit.
Shape-shifting.
Picks you up?
Yeah.
Holy
strong guy.
Balls.
He is very strong. He is a dinosaur.
Fuck.
He's not, like, actually a dinosaur. He's more like how we like to imagine dinosaur people in the 90s, but whatever.
I didn't know we thought about what dinosaur people look
oh,
like.
Oh, we thought about we it need, a lot.
I did not.
I had cable growing up. I saw a lot of cartoons.
Does anyone remember the film, the classic film, Super Mario Brothers?
Oh, yes. I do, yes.
The Koopas? Remember the Koopas? Uh-huh. That's what I imagined.
Another I like that you called it a film. That's a value judgment.
It's a cinematic film.
A cinematic masterpiece.
A motion picture.
Another thing I've never seen. Yeah,
it's one of those things where
I love it.
I want to like it. I actually do, because I feel like it has a cool aesthetic, but still a shit movie.
If you don't think of it as Super Mario Brothers, the game, and just think of it as a film in itself, in sort still of a bad. Post-apocalypse alternative world, then it's pretty great.
I'll take
pretty great on. Universe that they built.
It's like, I might have to evaluate those claims, but I will.
Okay, so Swole, I need you to roll Take a Powerful Blow for Charlie, because you are being used as a weapon, and I need to see how bad you do.
So I'm rolling. Okay.
Yes.
Nice. Failure.
It's a 5.
All right, so it's... He flings... So you get flung right at Charlie, but Charlie, you dodge it.
Oh. Oh, do I not roll because I...
Well, I was having him roll because he's a weapon, and I thought it'd be interesting.
Oh, okay.
And do I get to mark potential? For failing?
Yes.
Yay. Potential.
And he's making a break for it.
That's not fucking happening.
Yeah, that ain't happening.
Mm-mm.
Well, I would like to use my force push to trip him.
Oh. James V, 1971, has given the table 3 rerolls.
Oh, yay!
All right. Yay. Who doesn't get it? Oh, Steven's just putting him out there. Because we...
It here. Says for the table, so everyone
for the
has
table.
Actually.
Yeah, you know what?
Even
let's,
me.
Let's all. Oh.
No, that's bullshit. You have 2 already. Yeah. That's bullshit.
The District GM 11 says is goes. Island.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, I would like to use my psychic weapons to trip the guy as he's running away.
Okay.
9.
Nice.
Plus. Freak.
This is directly engage a threat, right?
This sounds like it, yeah.
Okay. Plus danger, which would be plus 1, 10.
Hey.
So on a 10, I get to pick 2.
Yes.
1, I guess it would be create an opportunity for my allies.
That is definitely happening.
And 2, I will choose impress, surprise, or frighten the opposition.
All right, well, he is definitely both. He is definitely surprised. As you catch him off guard, he stumbles, and he falls onto the table he threw at you guys, and it splinters to a million pieces.
Great.
My steak, god damn it!
Steak, like wooden steak, because there's plenty of those now.
I don't get it.
Yeah, he broke the table.
More like splinters if it's a million pieces, right?
Oh my god, just someone do something already.
Don't you? Is
I created
it...
an opportunity for my ally.
You guys have an opportunity. Go ahead.
Okay.
Whoever goes next gets plus 1 on the roll.
All right. Well, I want to. I can't do that. That's an adult move.
Anyone want to somehow restrain him?
Yeah.
Or pierce the mask. I don't know.
No, actually, I kind of want to pierce the mask. Except, no, that's good. Yeah, piercing the mask.
So are we?
Yeah,
it's
eight
plus mundane,
plus one.
Seven.
Damn. No, plus the one that I so get.
Eight.
So it's eight.
So it's still eight.
Well, but I have negative one. So yeah.
So it's eight. Zero.
Yeah.
But you still get to ask one.
Okay.
What are you really planning? What do you want me to do? What do you intend to do? How can I get your character to blank? And how can I gain influence over you?
What are you really planning?
How can I get your character to blank?
What is the connection to Red Dragon?
Where is Red?
We work together sometimes. What do you want?
We need to find him. He's the key to the Green Inferno.
Wow. Well, if you're looking for him, he's probably in the strip, helping me with my little bank robbery.
We're turning this guy in now, right?
Yeah, very much so.
I'll be out in a week.
You can bet your ass you're not. Just
we're leaving you a terrible Yelp review.
Oh, not that.
My family has been eating here for so many years. I'm so, so mad.
Oh, like a personal problem.
Oh, it's personal.
Oh, come on. It's good for you.
It was
delicious. Be honest.
I'm guessing the meat hooks are still in him.
Yeah.
And I'm guessing he's also on the ground.
Oh, Jack, do not do the torture.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, I have to go online.
I have
to a psychopath.
I have a fearsome reputation.
This isn't a Mark Millar comic. Come on.
I'm mad.
Remember, rules explicitly state
you're not murderers. No, I just want to wiggle one around a little bit. Just to remind
him. That's fucking better. Terrible.
That's not better. I'll let you do it.
Let you do it. Fine, I won't do it.
Thank you.
If the table doesn't accept it, that's fine. Whatever.
The group doesn't accept it.
I just feel
Charlie, what are you doing? She says, she's the leader.
I'm just...
It'd be like a psycho move.
Wait, what was the move going to be?
I'm just going to wiggle one of them.
Take the meat hooks that are inside them and like...
No, I wasn't going to take it out. I was just going to wiggle it around.
That's not better.
It's fucked up.
I just...
That's a special kind of gross.
Whatever. I mean, to be fair, he eats human flesh and serves it to people who don't know.
Yeah, no, he's kind
Thank
of evil.
You.
Oh, okay.
Thank
he's a psycho,
you.
So we can be psychos.
I mean, comparatively,
we have to be better than them.
And relatively,
and there is a
that is better
bank
than
robbery
them.
Possibly involving Red Dragon occurring on the strip right now.
Shit.
Should we run out there? Or should we ask this guy?
I think we need to take this guy in as quickly as we can. Like, maybe do like a Rorschach style, truss him up and leave him in front of a police office. Kind of thing.
Oh, I'm all aboard for that.
Yeah. Then we need to get to the bank.
The strip.
Where is the police station?
Oh yeah.
Every district has their own.
Okay. Let's drop it at an Aegis station. An Aegis.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
Aegis
better.
Has every odd number district has an Aegis station.
Alright, so
seven.
We go to Midway on our way to the strip.
There you go.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Jordan, go ahead and add that to the map.
Wait, there's a Bank of America ATM in Bayview. Are they robbing an ATM?
It's a bank.
Okay, fine. Well, then I'm going to say that the bank is here.
No, because it's not in the strip. He said it's in Bayview.
No, I said it's in the strip.
The bank's in the strip. The
Bayview doesn't have a bank.
Aegis is in
Bayview is still underwater.
What?
Okay, I'm going to say that...
You're making us go out of the way for the bank or for Aegis?
Yeah, it's worth it.
See, now to me, this is still the classiest of classy places to go because the one place that was supposedly classier served human flesh.
So, this is,
I'm distraught over the loss of Bayview.
The people tasted really good, though.
As people are wont to
do. Right, this direction.
I heard we taste like pork.
Mm-hmm. I heard that pork is so delicious because genetically it's closer to human than most of the other animals we eat. Mm.
Fun fact, I don't actually like pork.
Mm. All right.
I'm not supposed to eat pork, but...
Okay, you're joining the reform sect. We don't have to keep kosher.
I know.
You guys are... So it's not hard to find the bank in the strip that's getting robbed. Mm-hmm. It's just Hyperion City Bank.
On the way out, can we also yell...
It's people.
Tyrant food is people! It's people!
Well, thankfully, the restaurant was mostly abandoned because all the guys who worked there saw that, oh shit, the boss got caught. And they all scattered, and it left a huge mess, and people freaked out. And...
lame.
Yeah.
Cool.
I don't think we're getting that bread.
No. Hey. All right, Michael, go ahead and tell, draw us on the map where the bank is.
Okay.
Don't put in your Bayview. I want that place to be bank-free, except for the ETMs.
What's your obsession with Bayview?
He thinks that that's like where successful people go.
There could have been a bank near Bayview. The ATM could be like a Chase ATM.
Yeah, having a bank could be useful.
Oh my God! So you guys find yourselves
shopping center?
No, I'm saying there's.
You're
ATMs
at the Bank of Hyperion
sure.
City that in the Strip, and banks. It's currently being robbed by a bunch of guys who kind of look like they're dressed up as dinosaurs.
Oh, what a bunch of dicks. And we're arguing about banks.
Yes, you're arguing about bank locations. And Red Dragon's not with them.
Aww.
The cops are very happy to see you, though.
Sup, guys?
Oh, thank God. We need you guys.
What?
Well, we're looking for Red Dragon, but I guess we're here now.
Red who?
Red Dragon.
I don't know who that is.
Am I getting the name wrong?
No. What do you mean you don't know who Red Dragon is?
How about this? Reed Dragon?
Kevin, you're not
okay, we're wasting time.
Reed Dragon?
I've never heard of this film before in my life. Anyway, look, we got a bunch of guys dressed up as dinosaurs in there. They have really weird weapons. They got some hostages.
All right.
So I make myself look like one of them. No, I make myself look like T-Rex.
Mm.
Oh, okay. This could go badly, guys.
No.
Let's do
Kevin,
it.
This is your time to shine.
Okay, cool.
But wait.
Cool.
When you're in there... repeat what I tell you to say. Don't go off script, okay?
I love this movie. All right, let's see how this rolls out.
This is better than swallowing in.
Okay, fine.
Puns blazing.
Should I still have my communicator, even though I lost my phone?
Yes, you have your communicator.
Okay. Yeah, you absolutely still have your communicator.
All right, well then I attach the earpiece Bluetooth thing to it, so it's in my ear and I don't have to be caught. Yeah. Anyway, I bust in.
And you look like T-Rex.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, Mooks, what's going on in here?
No, of course I would know what's going on.
Shit. Okay, hold on.
Hey, you
Boss,
Mooks.
Boss,
I can see that you guys are screwing up here. What are the police doing here? This is supposed to be in and out.
Actually, that was pretty good.
One of them holding, kind of looks like a fancy laser gun, looks around and he's like, Boss, we wanted the cops here.
Of course. I was just testing you.
Yeah, I knew that, but there's clearly not enough.
I mean, I could shoot this guy. Please don't shoot me.
No, I have to come in and start saving our asses, our
You're
tails.
You're doing great, Kevin. Just don't, please don't let anybody die.
A genuine concern.
All right, yes. Tell me, give me
this
an update.
This lady's got a baby. You want me to shoot the baby?
Oh, fuck.
No, don't
We should probably go in, right?
Shut up.
Jesus.
This plan is freaking me out.
All right, give me a status update. What's
Look,
currently happening?
There's going to be a back
Well,
right?
Let's find it. We came in, guns blazing. That guy looks like he's bleeding out pretty good. And the bomb should be set at the hospital.
Okay.
What?
Good to know.
I'm going to the hospital!
Glad that that's all set up. Just a question. Is this the hospital in 9 candles?
Boss, like, is there another one you want us to blow up? That's Aegis one.
I turned to...
Chuck! Chuck! Yeah?
I'm going to the
hospital!
It's Aegis
one, right? Yeah, it's Aegis one. Okay, good. Yeah, it's the Aegis one.
Great.
Ah!
Well, then, I see that things are under control. I'm going to take this bleeding guy so I can eat him.
You sure you want to, boss? He doesn't look that, like, edible.
Are you going to tell me what I can't eat?
Hey. I'm revving up the firearm. Like, get in the fucking car.
Hey, cops, we just found out that this is just a distraction.
What?
And we're going to go to a hospital.
Hospital?
Yeah.
He's already on the radio.
I'll meet you guys there.
Wait, then how do I save all the people in the bank, guys?
Figure it out.
We didn't.
We'll find that out next week.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Oh, what a cliffhanger.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tasty.
Thank you for tuning into Mass. It was a weird session. Thank you to Sci-Fi T-Rex, our Patreon backer, for really switching this game up.
Yeah.
I had plans. You ruined them, and I love you for them. Make sure to follow me on Twitter at StephenJPope22. Also, check me out on my blog, skipaturn.com. And also occasionally on Geek and Sundry now. I'll be writing for them freelance-wise. Cool. So, pretty awesome.
Hi, I'm Jordan Pridgeon. You can check me out on Twitter at Jordan Pidgeon. Also, check out This American Lie. It is a podcast. We haven't done a new one in a while. But it is available online, so check out This American Lie on Facebook. Also, check out youtube.com/SeniorDitchDay for videos I do, and check out the Nerdist School, YouTube, and there's videos that I make on there. Tune in Monday night here for Monday Night Dungeon Fight, because I was supposed to be on it before, but Tom Lommel got sick, and so now I'm going to be on it this week. So what? Check it out Monday. It's going to be great.
Yeah.
Still need one more person.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
And we're looking for one more on that show, apparently. I can't do it, so...
What show? What is it?
Monday Night Dungeon Fight.
7:30 Monday. You want on?
Yes.
Tell him. I don't know what it is, but...
Yeah.
It's the reason we have all the maps on the walls.
I'll tell him you're in if you...
Yeah, that someone just needs to explain to me how it works.
It'll be explained the day of...
Just show up.
It's really easy.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, great.
Super easy. I'm Jack Kelly. You can follow me on Twitter at Jackson Alexander. A in the Alexander is the only vowel in that. I'm on Instagram at Steak Me Home Tonight. Steak spelled like the food that we talked about all day. I'm raising money for my top surgery. You can find it on GoFundMe at Jack Gets Something Off Their Chest. I run Hamilton's LA, which is a Hamilton sing-along group. We've kind of just started doing things again because we had to go on a brief hiatus. What else am I doing? Am I doing other things?
I don't know. What about your life?
No. Okay. So tomorrow is 125 in Laurel is my friend's bi-coastal sort of like production collective, and they're doing a protest sing-along called Hear the People Sing. It's on Facebook, and it is tomorrow night, and it's a musical theater sing-along, so if that's your jam, you should find it on Facebook, or follow me, and I will, retweet that shit.
All right, it was me, Nicole, playing Chaos a lot. You can follow me on Itchy Brained or on Twitter and Instagram. And I don't have anything major to plug, except I perform at Nerdist every Sunday on the Improv Group Biff. This Sunday we're playing at 6:30. But other than that, I would encourage you to either go to your local airport to protest the Muslim ban and help anyone who is struggling to get back into the country because they have a visa or a green card and are not 100% American, apparently. Mm-hmm. And do what you can. Donate to the ACLU. Do everything you can, because this is nuts.
Michael R. Holmes on Instagram. I would like to actually take a moment and thank Stephen for his empathy. It's been a very difficult week for me and my little corner of the world, and you've been there for all of it, and I appreciate that. Take care, do good, be well, and safe home.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for tuning in. We will not be having Phoenix Dawn Command today, but make sure to tune in tomorrow for Maximum Miniatures. And once again, special thanks to Dom Zook.
Yeah!
Yay!
With that, we will see you next week. So, bye everybody!
Bye! 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 Bye!